The Children's TV Workshop presents Sesame Street Show 850, produced in color in New York at Reeves Teletape.
Taking care of it right now. He had to go to the library to get some books because, you know, he's going to night school. So, in celebration of that, he said to give everybody a free cookie today. Isn't that nice of Mr. Looper? I mean, Hooper? Yeah, well, let me just put these cookies out. Mmm, oh, they look good. I'll put them out here in the window where everyone can have one cookie. They sure look good. Cookie Monster.
Cookie!
Hi there.
Can me have cookie, Big Bird?
Oh, sure. Mr. Looper said every person could have one cookie.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Thank you. Cookie! Oh, delicious. Thank you, Big
Yummy,
Bird.
Huh?
Now, me take other one cookie.
No. Mr. Looper said only one for each person. If you eat all the cookies, they want anybody any left for all the other people.
But Big Bird, please. Me cookie monster. Me got to have cookie.
Mm-mm.
Please. Mm-mm. Please, me begging. Monster begging. Look, bag. Cookie,
sorry.
Please. Rolling over and begging. Please.
Touching, but no.
What me going to do? Me so hungry, Big Bird, please.
I'm sorry. I have to save a cookie for the next person.
You got the safe cookie for the next person. Next person who come along, get cookie?
That's right.
Me got idea. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Hi, Dad. You're angry, aren't you? I can tell. But I love you anyway, even when you're angry.
Hi, it's me, Cookie Monster. Me fool you, huh? Me got Bert's hair and Bert's clothes. Me look like Bert, yeah. And me going to sound like Bert, so then me get Bert's cookie. Yeah, let's see, see what me do sound like Bert, huh? Say, hi, Ernie. Hi, Ernie. Testing 1, 2, 3. That's it. Hi, Ernie. Hi, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Cookie. Oh, Bert.
Bert.
Wait a minute. Bert, you look a little funny today.
Oh?
You sure you're Bert?
What you mean, sure me, Bert? Sure, me, Bert.
Well, let me see. Well, you got Bert's funny tuft of hair on the top of your head.
That's my hair.
Oh, your hair.
My hair.
Oh, well, and you got the right shirt on, Bert.
Yeah, my shirt.
Oh, yeah, and you got those little saddle Oxford shoes there. Oh, you're Bert, all right. I'm sorry. Well, what can I do for you, Bert?
Well, me want cookie, Big Bird.
Oh, sure. Mr. Looper said that everyone could have one cookie today, so help yourself to a cookie.
Thank you, Big Bird.
Enjoy.
Me will.
Good, huh?
Oh, it was delicious. Thank you, Big Bird.
Okay.
We have another cookie.
I have to save some for the next person.
Oh, for the next person.
That's right.
Okay. Bye-bye, Big Bird.
Bye-bye, Bird.
Thank you for the cookie.
It's okay. Say hi to Ernie.
I will.
Boy, those cookies sure are popular.
Oh, hi. It's me, Cookie Monster. Me pretend to be Susan this time. See, got Susan hat, nurse's hat, got Susan nurse's bag. Yeah, then me get cookie that really for Susan. Oh, okay, now me get Susan's voice. Hello, Gordon. Hello, Gordon.
Hello, Gordon. Big Bird, me want cookie, please.
Sure, Susan. Hey, is that you, Susan?
Who it sound like, Big Bird?
Well, it sounds like you, Susan, but the way you look.
Ooh, you mean this nurse's hat and this nurse's bag, Big Bird? Nobody wears nurse's hat but me. So stop talking, Big Bird. Give me cookie so I can go to work.
Oh, hi, Susan.
scratch that cookie order, Big Bird. Got to go now.
Bye-bye. Oh, boy.
Big Bird, what was that all about?
Don't ask, Susan. Just take your one cookie and don't ask.
There's a little flower pushing through a crack in the sidewalk. Watch it taking its time. Though it's hidden in the corner of a great big white oak, still it's gonna climb. It's gonna grow each day in every way, just like me and you. The little flower pushing through the crack in the sidewalk has got some. Watch him slide on the floor. Though he's making lots of noise and making lots of clutter, soon he'll learn some more. He's gonna grow each day in every way, just like me and you. The little puppy rolling like a big ball of butter has got some.
Bert.
Hey, what's the matter?
Nothing, Bert. Nothing. It's just that...
Yeah, what?
Well, I don't know. I just feel terrible, Bert.
Why do you feel terrible?
Well, because, well, there's nothing special about me, Bert. It's just that I'm plain, ordinary Ernie or something. I don't know. It's just...
You. Hey, Ernie. Special. Hey, come on. Turn around. Ernie, look at me. That's not true.
Oh, yeah?
That is not true. You're special. Everybody's special.
Well, what's special about me, Bert?
Oh, well, not... Take your nose, for example. Feel your nose. Go ahead. Feel your nose.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, that is a special nose. That's an Ernie nose.
Well, I've never seen a nose like this on anybody else, Bert.
Of course not. And how about your hair? Your hair
My
is
hair?
Special.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, nobody else has that kind of hair.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you got that special hair.
Gee.
And how about your ears? Look at those ears. Those are special.
Are they special ears,
Those
Bert?
Are very special
wow.
Ernie ears. Yeah, you're a special person, Ernie.
Hey, gee. Thank you, Bert. You've made me feel a lot better.
Well, it's all true, Ernie.
Oh, gee whiz. Hey, you. Why are you looking like that? You know, you're a special person, too. Sure you are. Why, feel your nose. Go ahead. Feel your nose. Yeah, that's a very special nose you're feeling there. Now run your fingers through your hair. You know, like that? Ooh. Yeah, that's very special hair you've got there. And now take your fingers and wiggle them. Everybody wiggle their fingers like that, see? See there? That's a very special finger wiggling you're doing there. So smile. You're a very special person, too. Like me.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Q, R, S. T, U, V. W, X, Y, Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
I'd love to.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Q, R, S, T, U, V. W, X, Y, Z. Now I know my ABCs. I am glad you sang with me.
You're lucky, Mort. All I got in my lunchbox is peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Here is a shoemaker holding a ruler. He measures your foot to find a shoe that fits. Some shoes are this long. Some are this long. And some are this long.
So it's good to have a ruler around.
Huh? Hi, Oscar.
Yeah, have a rotten day.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Oh, hey there. Oh, Susan.
Hi, Grover. How
Hi, you look
Grover.
So pretty.
Oh, thank you. Isn't that nice? That's
Just listen
nice
to him.
Hi, Raphael. Hey, Yvette.
Some monster. How nice
oh,
it is today, Susan.
You know
All that
I've
kind
just
of
been
stuff.
Running around looking at the flowers.
He never gets angry or anything. Yeah. Always
this is a pretty
nice.
Day, you know?
I'll bet I could get him angry.
Nice.
Yeah, I bet I could.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Grover!
Oh, excuse me a minute.
Oh, Grover, come here.
Hello there. Hi,
Hi
Greenwood. Nice
buddy
to see
there.
You. Nice to see you.
Well, it's not nice to see you.
Oh? Why?
No, it's rotten to see you. It ruins my whole day.
But what do you, I mean, what? You want me to leave? Are you coming over?
No, you stay right here. Nothing gets not... to this guy here. I gotta have to be rougher here. I'll get him angry. Hey, you know something?
Hmm? Yes, Grouchy, yes.
Just the sight of you makes me so sick. I'm gonna move out of my trash can down to South Washback, the dullest town in the world.
I did not know that you... I mean, I did not know that when I... Wait a minute. Why do you say that? That is not very nice.
Yeah, it makes you angry, huh?
Well, it does not make me feel good.
No.
Well, as a matter of fact, it makes me feel angry.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I was just talking to Susan and the kids, and you asked me to come here, and now you are talking mean to me?
Uh-huh.
As a matter of fact, yes, I am angry.
He's angry.
You have no right to call me over here.
He's angry.
And then all
He's
of a sudden, tell me that all those bad things.
Yeah.
I am angry. And Oscar, I do not want you to talk to me that way ever again.
Uh-huh.
No, you should not talk to anybody that way ever again, okay? Just don't do it. I am angry. So just from now on, you just cut it out.
Wow. I got you angry, all right. That was beautiful. Keep that up. That was really great.
That's right.
Now that's great. Stay that way. Yeah.
Well, yeah. I'm certainly glad I got that off my fur.
Well,
I feel a lot better now.
Huh?
Well, so, Oscar. Oh, well, nice trash can. You redecorated?
Come on, you're supposed to be angry there.
Hey, look at the little trees and the sky. Isn't it pretty out there now?
Cut it out. I don't want to hear nice, sweet stuff. Oh, no. Now, knock it off.
What? I was angry and I got it off my fur, and I'm fine now. What are you doing in a trash can? You redecorating?
No.
Oh, look at that. That is sweet down there. That little window.
Tortilla contest.
Un concurso de tortillas. Está haciendo la masa.
She's kneading the dough. Now they're rolling the dough.
Ahora están aplastando la masa.
You have to hurry to the stove. Then you cook the tortilla.
Ahora están cocinando más. Ahora van a cocinar más.
Seis pulgadas de largas, de grandes. ¡Uy, se están largas! ¡Ya lo compuse! ¡De redondas!
You put meat in the tortilla and make a taco.
Están haciendo los tacos de tortillas.
It's really delicious.
I like them. Bonitos.
Hail to thee, alma mater, Roosevelt Franklin, elementary school, elementary school.
Man, you can't do nothing about it.
Baby Breeze, you just acting simple now.
I'm still mad.
Well, you shouldn't be.
Well, what I should be and what I is two different things.
Well, I still say you can't do nothing about it. And besides that...
Hush, y'all. Here comes Roosevelt. Come on, everybody. Sit down. Here's Roosevelt.
That's right. Here I come. And now, what's the matter with you, baby Breeze?
He's mad. He's mad.
He sure is.
Yeah. So silly thing, mad.
What about?
I'll tell you what I'm mad about. I was supposed to go on a picnic today after school, and now it's raining, and I can't go.
Well, sometimes that's the way it is.
Yeah, sometimes, but it didn't have to be this time. I'm mad, and that's all there is to it.
Well, I tell you what to do. If you're that mad, you go outside and beat up the raindrops. Go right outside and take it out on the raindrops.
All right, man. You think I'm not bad enough to do that? Okay. As mad as I am, that's just what I'm going to do. I'm going to take care of
it. Now, Roosevelt Franklin, what did you tell him to do that for?
You just wait and see.
You job, raindrop. You messed up my whole day. Come on, man. Stand still. I want to have a picnic and you messed it up. Hey, man, come on, stand still and fight like a man. You know, I want to beat you up. Keep still, raindrop, so I can. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Now I'm going to get you for messing up my picnic.
Now, I done seen some dumb, dumb things in my day, but that's the dumbest thing I ever seen.
Why, it's just ridiculous.
He ought to feel just like a fool.
I feel like a fool. Out here trying to beat up raindrops. The raindrops are coming down. I'm supposed to be getting back to them, and all I'm getting is wet. I feel like a fool. Hey, y'all. You know what I feel like?
A fool.
Well, yeah. It just goes to show you how dumb it is to get all mad about something you can't do nothing about.
Just another number one rule from the Roosevelt Franklin Elementary School.
Ship ahoy, anchors away. Grover is about to go for a cruise in his rowboat. Yeah. Hey, guys. Hey. Now, the thing to remember when you are in a rowboat is that some people have to sit at that end of the boat, and some people have to sit at that end of the boat, okay? Okay, guys. Come on. Sit over in this end, guys. Over here. Come on, guys. Hey, over here. Hey, you guys. Hey, over here. This end, guys. Hey. I think we're going to have a problem here.
Q.
Quiet!
Okay, I think it is all repaired now. Hey, guys, you ready to try again?
Yeah.
Okay, now this time, remember, do not all go up to that end of the boat, okay? Because then, if you go up to that end, up to the tip, we will fall into the water like we did before. Right? We do not want that, do we? Okay, guys, come on in. Come on, let's go. Let's go, okay, over here. Somebody over here. Hey, guys, guys.
Well, I see. This is the day to meet the letter Q. And here is something beginning with the letter Q. It's a quarter. That's right, 25 cents.
Are you guys okay? You dried off?
Yeah.
Okay. The boat seems okay. Now listen. We still seem to be having a little trouble understanding about where to sit in the rowboat, right? Okay, now let's try it one more time. You see, if all of you sit at that end, or if all of you sit at that end of the rowboat, then the boat will sink. Now some of you sit at that end, and some of you sit at that end, and I'll be in the middle, okay? Now we'll try it one more time. Here we go. Come on, I'll be in the middle. Okay, you go there. You stay over there. Real careful, Mike. Careful. You go over there. Hey, that's pretty good. You are over there, and you are over there, and I am in the middle. Let's start rowing.
All right. Here we go.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
You know, my plants are really thirsty. While I've got them all out here, though, why don't we play three of these things?
Three of these plants belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. One of these things just doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play our game. Time to play our game.
Well, what do you think? Okay, tell me why you chose that one, Danny.
Because it has some pink and the other one's almost a yellow.
Okay, that's one right answer. There's another answer. Kate, do you see another answer? What?
Because...
Be careful. Which one? Because, this one? Yeah. Or that one? This one?
Yeah.
Why?
Because that one is like a dandelion. And all the others aren't.
Okay, but what else about it? Look at the number of blossoms. What about this, Danny? Huh? Every other one has one single blossom. And look, this one has a whole lot. I bet the count would have fun counting this one.
Yeah,
it has a lot. Well, it's going to be a nice sunny day, so they're going to get a lot of sun out here.
Hey, Bert. Are you asleep, Bert? Bert?
No, not anymore, Ernie. What is it?
Well, I can't sleep, Bert. I can't fall asleep.
Well, count sheep then, Ernie.
Count sheep? What do you mean, count sheep?
I mean, just lie there and count sheep. Imagine them one at a time until they get so sleepy you just fall asleep, okay?
Okay. I'll try it, Bert. All right, let's see. Counting sheep. See, that's one.
What was that?
That's just my first sheep. Don't worry, Bert. Just go in back to sleep. I'm just counting sheep. Another one. That makes two sheep. Another one. That makes three sheep. That makes four sheep. Counting sheep is a pretty dull thing to do, though. I'd like to count something more exciting than sheep. I know. I think I'll count fire engines. How about that? Okay, here we go.
What? What is it? What? I'm up. What is it?
Take it easy, Bert. That's just one. That's one.
One what?
Well, one fire engine, you see.
One fire engine?
Yeah, you see, I got bored counting sheep, so I decided I would count something more exciting than sheep.
Ernie!
So I decided to count fire engines, Bert. That was my first fire engine, you see. Okay, let's see. I'll count another fire engine. Here we go. Another one.
Ernie!
Makes two.
Oh, Ernie, but that is no good. You cannot count fire engines. That's too loud. You'll wake up the whole neighborhood. Now, I want you to count something quiet to fall asleep with, okay? None of those sirens.
Well, okay, Bert. Well, how about if I count, like, balloons?
Balloons?
Yeah, they're quiet. They just sit there, you know.
Okay, just count the balloons then. But count them now so I can get some sleep.
Okay, here we go. Counting balloons. One.
quiet!
Hello there. Yeah, it is me, Grover, and I'm here to talk to you today about big and little. And I'm a very good person to talk to you about that because I personally myself am little. Mm-hmm. See, I only reach these two belt buckles here. That is how little I am. Do you know who belongs to these two belt buckles? My friends, Susan and Gordon. Hi.
Hi.
Yeah. Hi.
See how big they are? Yeah. There are good things about being big. They are big. I am little. Big people can reach things that little people cannot reach. Like there's a book on that counter over there. Now, I'm just a little too short, little too little to reach it. But maybe, Gordon, could you reach it for me?
Sure, Grover.
Aha, see? He could reach it because he is bigger than me. He is big. Okay, yeah. Drop the book.
Drop it?
Yeah, just
drop
trust me. This is a visual demonstration. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Nicely done. Now, okay. I will show you some of the good things, or at least one of the good things, about being little. Okay? Here, we'll get this book here. Oh, that is a heavy book. You know that? That is not so heavy for you, because you are big, but for me, I am little. It is heavy. Anyway, that is one good thing you can do if you're little. You can pick up the book. You see, I am closer to the ground than they are. So I could get the book first.
That's a good point.
Boy, this is a heavy book. I think I'm going to drop it. I think that ends our visual demonstration about big and little.
What's the matter? You know, tired?
Yeah, you know the best thing about being little?
No.
You can ask somebody. I'm not mentioning names. But somebody to carry me home because I'm so tired, Susan.
Oh, you're not mentioning names.
Would you please?
Okay.
Oh, this is the part I love
oh,
best.
Wait a minute, Grover, you gained some weight.
No, I just ate lunch.
Oh, goodness.
I see you guys, huh?
Bye-bye. I'll be back in a minute.
Okay.
The letter Q is very queer. Q. It starts like this, then turns up here. Q. It's found in quack and quiz and no Q. The Q in queen and quart and quote. Yes, Q asks questions. Q is quaint. Q. It starts like A, but then it ain't. Q. There's Q in quiz and quake and quack. Q. It's like a G that broke its back. Remember Q because it's queer. It starts like this and turns up here. Remember Q because it's quaint. It's like an A but then it ain't. However you remember Q, hey, I don't care. But remember Q, well, because it's there. Q.
There's a bird on me. I can't tell if there's one or two or ten or three. Don't want to complain or raise a fuss, but them birds up there think I'm a motor bus. Oh, gee, there's a bird on me. Oh, don't you see? There's a bird on me. They sit there talking to each other, not to me. Now, how do I find a way to explain that I'm not a boat or a railway train? Little birdie, fly away. Don't you come back no other day. Shoo. Well, can't you see? There's a bird on me. Oh, woe is me. There's a bird on me. I'm so darn sick of every feathered friend. Oh, gee. Stop your chirping and quack, quack, quack. Come on, bird. Get off of my back.
Hello there. At this time, my old buddy Bert and I are going to tell you about the words tall, taller, and tallest.
Right.
Now, as you can tell, I am pretty tall. See old Ernie. See how tall he is.
That's true.
But you see, you are taller, you see? See, he's up there, and I'm down here. That makes him taller.
Yeah, that's right, Ernie. I am taller than you are.
Yes, isn't that fun?
Yeah. Hey, what about tallest, though?
Hmm?
What about tallest? See, you said you were going to explain about tall, taller, tallest. So you've talked about tall and taller, but what about tallest?
Oh, well, don't worry about that, you see.
Oh, okay.
As I was saying, I am tall,
yep.
But Bert is taller.
Mm-hmm.
But now here comes somebody who's even tallest of all.
Who's that?
Come on in.
Big Bird.
Oh, hi, everybody.
Hey, watch out for the...
Okay.
Coffee table.
Sorry about that.
Ernie, you can't bring this bird in here.
Oh, you see, I'm just explaining. I am tall. Bert here is taller. And
I'm tallest.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, watch out! Right through the ceiling.
Boy, isn't this fun? Now we know all about tall, taller, and tallest.
I'm tall, dee-dum. I'm tall, dee-dee.
Tall. Did you say that you... How can you say a thing like that? How could you be tall? How could you be tall? Never mind what the... Well, tall is being stretched way up here. But you and I are the same size. Is that right? You see that? We are the same exact size. And if I am short, then how can you possibly be tall?
Oh, how can I be tall? Let's see. How can I be tall when you are short? I don't know. I give up, Shorty. How?
Never mind. You're getting water on me.
Casa. 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 Mi casa. Casa.
Ladies and gentlemen, direct your attention, please, to the center ring where the marvelous Maria B.
performs her tricks to the count of 10. There she goes, ladies and gentlemen. 1. Isn't that fantastic? 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. Oh, it's all right, folks. She's just fine. What a performer. What a trooper. Here she goes now. 8. 9. 10. Oh, that's wonderful. And now the same thing backwards. 10. 9. 8. 7. 7. Oh, what a fantastic. 6. What a fantastic performer. 5.
Casa. Casa. Casa.
And now for another fast-breaking news story, we take you to Kermit the Frog.
But as soon as we finish her, then we can...
hi there, Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News. And today I'm speaking to you from the lovely town of Hamlin, which, as you may remember, is unfortunately overrun with mice. And you can see the mice up there overrunning that house right there right now. And I understand that the town council has hired the Pied Piper to get rid of the mice of the town. And I think this might be him right now. Excuse me. Pardon me, sir. Pardon me?
Hey, you're a frog. Far out.
Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News, actually, Mr. Piper. And I was wondering if I can just ask you a couple of questions.
Yeah, well, call me Pied, baby. Pied.
Pied?
Yeah,
okay.
Pied.
Do you mind if I ask you a question then?
Right on.
Tell me, how do you intend to get the mice out of the town?
Yeah, well, babe, going to lay down some music with the old flute here. The mice are going to dig it, see, and they're going to follow me out of this hick town.
You're going to play the flute, and the mice will follow you out of town.
Right on.
Well, I would love to see that, and so would our viewers.
Okay.
Would you like to play it right now? Huh?
Right on, baby. Here we go now. Here we go.
That was beautiful.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks,
I don't
baby.
See any mice coming. There's nobody...
Frog, I tell you, let me warm my chops in, baby. Let me try one more time, okay?
Okay, yeah.
Here we go.
One more try.
Hey, man, hey, now I'm laying this stuff down, and these mice just ain't picking it up,
yes,
Dick.
It doesn't seem to be working particularly well.
Yeah, well, okay, one more time, okay?
Okay.
Here we go.
Didn't seem to work there.
Baby, ain't working. No, I got other gigs. I don't need this, baby. I'm cutting out. No, sorry, baby.
Well,
bye-bye, baby.
I guess that's it from the town of Hamlin. Okay, fellas, I guess we can pack up now. Let's move up.
Hey, what was that sound, babe?
You mean my whistle like this?
Hey, babe, that did it. Hey, whistle some more, baby. Hey, come on, whistle more. Go ahead, whistle. Hey, you got the mouse running. Go ahead, come on, start walking, baby, start walking. Okay, go up that path up there now, baby. Oh, yeah.
Well, this is Kermit the Frog returning you to Sesame Street News, huh?
Hey, they're leaving. Stop blowing, baby. Blow. Whistle, baby, whistle. Okay, up that path, baby. Keep going. Head
Hey, let's play a sound game, all right?
Okay.
Can everybody make sounds?
Yeah.
Okay, now you have to really help me out now. We're going to make some city sounds, all right? Okay, listen. As I was walking down the street, I heard a sound with a brand new beat. I caught a cab, might have been my last. That taxi driver drove so fast. And the taxi went, ha, ha, ha. Come on, say it with me.
Ha, ha, ha.
And all these sounds go round and round, cause that's the way the city sounds. Hey, that's pretty good. Let's try another one. As I was walking down the street, I heard a sound with a brand new beat. I looked around and don't you know, I spied this cat with the radio. And the radio went do-do-do, and the taxi went ha-ha. And all these sounds go round and round, cause that's the way the city sounds.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Sign said, slow sidewalk repair. The noise was more than I could bear. Was a hammer run by air, and the hammer went drrrr. And the radio went doo-doo. And the taxi went ha-ha. As I was walking down the street, I heard a sound with a brand new beat. A bus pulled up, I stepped inside. The driver took me for a ride. And the big bus went boom, boom. And the hammer went drrr. And the radio went doo-doo. And the taxi went
ha-ha.
And all the sounds go round and round, cause that's the way the city sounds. And then I heard another sound. Screeching came from underground. The subway train around, and the subway went
screech, screech.
And the big bus went boom, boom. And the hammer went brrr. And the radio went doo doo. And the taxi went hop, hop. One more. I was walking down the street, I heard a sound with a brand new beat. A long red fire truck caught my eye. I heard the siren screaming by. Siren went, ah! And the subway went, screech, screech, and the big bus went, boom, boom, and the hammer went, boom, and the radio went, doo, doo, and the taxi went,
ah, ah!
And all the sounds go round and round, cause that's the way the city sounds.
This is the capital letter W. It's the first letter in the name Wilbur. Excuse me 1 minute, please. As I was saying, that's the capital letter W. Hey! That's the capital letter W. It's a real big letter.
I don't always look like a clown, you know. I have an everyday face, too. My nose goes in this box. My hair rests on this stand. My eyebrows go in this tube. The lines around my eyes belong in here. Color around my mouth goes in here. white on my face belongs in this tube. This is my everyday face. Which do you like best? Me too.
A good day, everyone. I am a worm. Worm begins with this letter, W. It's really the only important thing that does, you know. Except, of course, for walrus. And water.
Híjole, qué calor, mano. It's so hot. Oh, well, no wonder. Look at that hot sun up there. Oh, I'm dying in these clothes.
Snow, what's Snow doing down here? How am we going to the beach? Snow? I mean, sand? Oh, what is this? This is crazy. I don't understand.
Oh, so hot.
Hey!
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I should be over there with these warm clothes on.
I got a swimming suit on. I should be over on the beach. Yeah.
Hey! Let's switch, man.
That's a good idea.
Oh, here we go. Is that? And
yep. Here we go. Ah, made it, hot dog.
Ah, this is more like it, man. Yeah. Oh,
look at me. I'm in the sun. In the sun. Go on, baby. Get him.
Oh, now I feel right in it. Yeah, I think I'll build a snowman. Oh, there goes the body right there. And I put a head on there.
My trusty old beach ball and my beach blanket.
Hey,
man. What the hell? You're funny. I'm going to get you, man. All right.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here. And today you're going to help me draw another letter. Everybody,
hey,
want to help me draw another
Froggy?
Letter?
Hmm? Funny meeting you here. Hi, you. Can I watch you?
Yes. What's funny about it, though, Grover? I'm just
working
drawing a letter with the children at home.
Oh, okay. Can I watch, though?
Yes, you can.
Can I help my Froggy?
No. Just stand out of the way there.
Oh.
Okay?
Okay, where?
Okay, right there. That's
right
fine.
Here, right
yes,
here?
Right over there.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, now, today we're going to draw a letter, and we're going to start this letter by drawing a great big circle.
A circle, yes.
Yes, right. A great big circle. Going to take your finger and just draw a circle in the air with your finger. You don't have to come up to the television set or anything like that. Just stay right where you are and draw a circle here. And when I tell you to, you're going to go, yunk, like that.
That was good, Froggy.
Yeah, but we didn't do it.
Oh.
Now we're ready to do it. Everybody ready to do it? On your mark. Get set, go!
That was better even!
Wasn't that nice?
Wow!
Isn't that pretty?
Ooh.
Yes, indeed. But this is not the letter that we're going to draw.
No?
This is one letter. You know what letter this is?
Oh.
Right! This is indeed an O. But we're not finished yet because we're going to turn this O into another letter. Okay? And we're going to turn it into another letter by drawing a little piggly tail here, see?
Piggly tail.
Yes,
that's cute.
We're going to take a little straight line and we're going to go right there.
Okay.
Everybody ready to do that? Okay, here we go. Take your finger and you're going to go.
Very good, Froggy.
Now, you know what letter that is, Grover?
I think so.
What letter is this?
Q.
Q. This is indeed a Q.
Hey, Froggy, I'm going to do something now, too, okay? I'm going to erase this Q first. There. Okay, now here we go.
How'd you do that?
Wow.
Gee, what is that, Grover?
I don't know, but isn't it pretty?
And the tall bird said, never, never stand under a tall bird.
Why? Said the short bird.
That's why.
These are all sunflowers. When they started to grow, they were as tall as my ankles. Then they grew as tall as my tummy. Then they grew almost as tall as my shoulders. Then they grew as tall as my head. Then they grew much taller than me. So then the sunflower bloomed.
All right, get it moving on the ground, that's it, up the hill, go to the top, a little bit more, all right, hold it, that's it, all right, everybody now, all together. Here we go, hold up, look out, that's it, all right, get there, get away.
I got something here. I want to see if you know what this is.
A cube.
A cube? That's right.
Yeah, right there.
Do you know why that's a cube?
What?
Huh?
Cube.
Because it's round like a circle, and it has a little tail on it right there.
And it's gotta see it?
Yeah, that's it. And that is the letter Q, right?
Right.
Right, that's called a capital Q.
Bye-bye, I'm going to take a walk now. Bye-bye. Bye. Okay, see you tomorrow. Oh, what a nice day. Okay. Oh, bye-bye, Susie. Bye-bye. Oh, and a little grouchy. Oh, how sweet.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters Q and W and by the number 11. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.